Hello everyone, a warm welcome to all. Myself, Dr. S. Bhagyashree, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, University College of Engineering, Dindigul, Tamil Nadu. I am here to present you about how to create a simple website on WordPress. In this session, we will see the various options available to set up a simple website using WordPress. We have so many domains to create website. For simple functional website, we can go for WordPress because it is easy to install, it has strong community and open source. Hence, my recommendation is to use WordPress. Let us see how to set a new website using WordPress. To go for WordPress, we can directly type the URL wordpress.com and we can download it from wordpress.org website. Go to a WordPress website, in that click Get Started, which is shown in the top right corner of the screen. In the next page, we will get so many options like start with blog, start with website, etc. We can choose according to our need. Here I choose start with website. Then choose the theme of your own. Then give your name of your website. Let's check the availability of your website. And it will recommend some websites for you, and we can select a free website that will be recommended by the WordPress itself. This page shows the premium details of the website, and here I chose start with free option. Create your website account by registering your login details with the mail ID and get starts your web creation. When you start, it will directly take you to the website. This image shows my web page. Next, we will see how to configure the newly created WordPress website. Go to your website name.com/wp-admin/. Your WordPress admin menu is available on the left side of the screen. Allowing your cursor to linger over them, it will open the submenus. There you can see various menus like dashboard, post, media, links, pages, comments, etc. Let us see one by one. For customizing your site appearance and activating a WordPress theme, first open appearance, then themes. From here on, have a look at the headings of each subsection and click on the add new button on the top. And choose from one of the themes displayed or search for a specific theme. Install a new theme that you fancy and activate it. The next part involves the customization of themes. You can access this under the Appearance Customize option. You can do a number of themes to your site appearance from here, but that is not an important one for this course. A theme is sufficient to start a website. Widgets. Widgets or preset modules are pieces of code that add to a certain function which will prove useful for your website in some sort. Your sidebars, footers, and headers can be loaded with widgets. As you can see in the screenshot, there are some widgets in the sidebar. These widgets include a search bar, recent posts, recent comments, archives, search, contact info, etc. Then you can see four footer areas where you can add widgets just the same. The number of footer, header, and sidebar areas available to you depend on the theme you are using. Menus. Menus are extremely important for any website. They allow you to navigate your website and its content. You may have seen websites with menus on the top or the side and even at the bottom. We can do all of this, and you would like to include pages like about, blog, contact and other services as part of your primary menu. Any page you would like displayed on your menu can be added in this. The number of menus and their placement on your site depends on your WordPress theme. Likewise, we can change the background color through appearance background. Next, we will see how to add pages. Go to pages, then add new. Then pages on a website reflects the content of your site. Likewise, we can add post, media, links, tags, comments, testimonials, feedbacks to our site wherever required. This is my website. While you are waiting, let's start to build a new website of your own. Thank you for listening.